This weekend marks a momentous achievement for Queen Elizabeth, 70 years since she took the throne. But Brett McLeod tells us her Jubilee celebrations will be very different to all of the others, coloured by sadness and scandal.
For many people, this was the moment Elizabeth became Queen, but in fact, the crown had been hers for more than a year. In February 1952, as she waved goodbye to her father, King George VI, ahead of a trip to Africa, she couldn't have known how her life was about to change forever.
The tragic news reached Princess Elizabeth and her husband while in Kenya.
The king had passed away in his sleep at the age of 56. His daughter raced home. Prime Minister Winston Churchill on hand to greet his new monarch.
And then, bravely concealing her emotions, Queen Elizabeth II emerged.
The king was dead. Long live the queen. Since her teenage years, she knew one day she would rule. But her father's sudden death thrust her into the role when she was just 25.
She didn't even have a few years of sort of normal married life under her belt, that she was thrust into this position as a young woman, navigating a sort of very male political world.
Her first duty, the funeral of her father.
A king who had indeed spent his strength in the selfless service of his people.
In June 1953, she was sent to stage at the first televised coronation, the first mass media monarch. In 1977, crowds again surged outside Buckingham Palace for the Queen's 25th year. All senior members of the royal family, from her youngest to the Queen Mother, were on hand. Even then, at 50, she'd been monarch for a generation. Fast forward to 2012, a river parade to mark Her Majesty's 60 years on the throne. Soon she would be Britain's longest-serving monarch. The 70th anniversary of her accession will be a lonelier affair. No Philip by her side. Grandson Harry alienated from the royals after raising claims of racism, and son Andrew forced to give up his titles as he faces court over sexual assault claims.
Whether they are enough in themselves to make enough people in Britain think that as a result we should have no monarchy, I would doubt.
Others see it differently.
Polling amongst under 30s has shifted dramatically over the last couple of years, and now it's majority in favour of getting rid of the monarchy.
But for now, the 95-year-old's stoicism and longevity will see Britons once again fill the streets in June for the official celebrations as she begins her 71st year of ruling Britain. Cloud 9 News.